Hi you guys, welcome back to another edition of Math in a Hoodie. I've put on my favorite hoodie, and today we're going to break down the math concept of place value. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I have a number here on the board. Do you know what number that is? That's number 15, isn't it? We have a 1 and we have a 5. Now, did you know that even though the number is 15, that each of the numbers have a place value? So let's go ahead and first figure out and talk about what place value means so we understand. And then I'll show you how to figure out which one goes in the right spot, okay? So place value has to do with the order or the place, right? The place or the order of the numbers, okay? So in this one, we have 1 and 5. So this, the number 1 has to do with the value, right? 1 just means 1. That's the value. This is the number value, okay? And number 5 just means 5. It's the 5 value, okay? So we're not trying to figure out how much the numbers are worth, because we already know they're worth 1 and 5, huh? We're trying to figure out what the place value is. And the place value of a number has to do with the order of them. So let's talk about order for a minute. Let's say you had 3 dolls, okay? And you can put them in any order you want. Now, what's another name for order? We could say 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, huh? Or we could say back, middle, and front. We could do that too, huh? Or we could say 1st, middle, and last. See how they all have a place? But when we call them by their place, that doesn't change what they are, does it? It's still a doll. Whether it's first, it's still a doll. Whether it's middle, it's still a doll, huh? Or whether it's last, it's still a doll. So their place value doesn't change what they are. It's just telling us where their place is and what order they're in, okay? So that's what order or place means. And there's lots of ways you could tell somebody what the place is of an object. And in a number, we call it the place value, okay? So we're not changing the numbers at all, just like we didn't change the dolls. They're still dolls, no matter what place they were in. We're not changing the numbers. We're just figuring out what the place value is, okay? Okay, so let's figure out how we know which number is in what order or place value, okay? So when I try to figure out place value of numbers, I have a trick I use. I put together some columns, okay? So for this particular number, how many numbers do we have? We have 2 different numbers, so I made 2 different blocks, huh? If we had 3 numbers, I'd make 3 blocks. If we had 4 numbers, I'd make 4 blocks. But making blocks will help us know which number goes in what place, okay? Now, each block has a certain name, just like the dolls were 1st, 2nd, or 3rd, or front, middle, and back. Our place values for numbers have names too, okay? So the very first block we have here, we call this the 1's place, okay? And the next one, we call it the 10's place, okay? Now, do you think you know which one goes in which box? Do you know which number goes in which box? Well, how many 1's are there in 15? If we were to count by 15 on our fingers, how many fingers would we use? We'd use 15 because there's 15 ones, right? If we wanted to count to 15 by ones, we'd have to put 15 ones out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. There's 15 ones in 15, huh? Now, how many tens are there in 15? If we were to count off 10 of these ones, how many would we get? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we cross them off. Now, do we have enough left over to do another group of 10? We don't, huh? We only have 5 left over. That's half of 10. So how many groups of 10s do we have? We have 1, don't we? Just like it says, we have 1 group of 10 and 5 little ones left over. Did you see how we do that? We marked out the number and then we put it in groups of 10 so we knew how many goes in which box. When we do place value, we only count up to 10. Okay, so that means that I wouldn't have done. Let's see. Let's say we had our 2 boxes here, okay? And this was 10s and this was 1s. I wouldn't put there were 15 ones, would I? Even though you could. There are 15 ones if you wanted to count it that way. But when we do place value, we only have up to 10. We count to 10. And then as soon as you get to 10, you have a group of 10 and you can put 1 here. And then the rest are left over in the 1s, okay? So you will never have more than 9 in the 1s because once we hit 10, oh, we have a 10, and then the leftovers will be the 1s, okay? So in place values, we count by 10s. Okay, maybe another way to look at this is with blocks. Maybe you're familiar with blocks. You have them in your classroom. Your teacher has showed them to you before. So there's single blocks like this, and you could have 10 of them. But as soon as you get to 10, all of a sudden you have a block or a long rectangle, and this represents a group of 10, doesn't it? So this would be a 10, and then we'd have 5 little blocks left over as our 1s, because these are 1s, and oops, these are 1s, and this is a group of 10. And we only count by 10s in place value, huh? Okay, and we can only go up to 9 ones because as soon as we add our 10th one, boom, they all stick together and they become this big tall tower. Okay, so this is 10 and then we would have 9 single ones. Does that make sense? I know it takes a minute to think about, huh? But if you have these in your classroom, they'll help you remember that once you get 10 ones, it turns into a tower. Okay, so our 15 number was 1, 10, and 5 ones. Okay, should we do another one? Okay, guys, let's do another one, okay? I know this one kind of takes a few practices to kind of understand. So let's try another one. So I put the number 34 on the board, okay? So then I made my columns, right? And the very last column is the ones. And the second to last column is the tens, okay? All right, now remember the tens are the towers and the ones are the little tiny blocks that are by themselves left over, okay? All right, so we need to know which number goes in which column. So we could just look at it and say, okay, it's 34, let's mark out 34 dashes, and let's see how many groups of 10s are in it, shall we? So I did it in rows of 10. So here's 1 group of 10. Here's another group of 10. Here's the third group of 10. And then how many little baby ones are left over? 4, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4. 10, 20, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. So how many groups of 10, guys, was in the number 34? It was 3. And how many little ones are left over? 4. So we're gonna put that in the ones place. So 3 tens and 4 ones, that's 34. Now, did you notice that I had the number 34 and actually the end number is the 1? And the next number was the 10. It's kind of a trick. You could just look at this and say, well, the last digit's gonna be the ones, and the next digit's gonna be the 3, is gonna be the 10s, right? But if you mark it out too, you can double check and make sure that you're right, okay? Because as soon as we start adding more numbers, sometimes it can get harder. So you can either do it this way by identifying the number and putting them in the right column, or you can write it out and then count out by tens so you know how many tens or how many ones is in the number, okay? Okay, let's try one last number and we'll divide it into the columns. Okay guys, here is our last one where we're gonna take the number and put it into our columns, right? And these columns represent the place or the order value of the numbers, right? And remember, the place or the order doesn't change the numbers at all. It's just telling us in what order they come in, right? And the value of each of those places, okay? So the last number I put up is 20, okay? So I wrote out in groups of 10, right? Because we count in groups of 10 when we do place value. I wrote out 20 and I did them in groups of 10. So here's one group of 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So this equals 20. So how many groups of 10 did we have, guys? Let's see. We had one group of 10 and we had two groups of 10. So let's write that in our tens column. We had two groups of tens. How many ones are left over? Are there any baby ones down here, guys? There's not. So what are we gonna put in our ones? Well, you know what? Even though zero means zilch or nada, it still has a place value. It still is last. It still is a digit that has a place. So we have to put it in the ones. And that just tells us, nope, there's no ones. There's no numbers in the ones place, is there? There's two tens, but there's zero ones. Does that make sense? Okay, now remember, you could also just write the number and you would be able to tell the last number is the ones and the second number is the tens, right? So if you don't want to draw it out, if you can look at the number and see which digit goes in which place value, then you can just write them directly in. Let's try that real quick. What if we had the number 14? Do you know which one would go in what? The last number would be the one, so that would be four. So let's put a four in here. And how many tens would there be? The next number would be the tens. See how we did that? What if the number was 35, guys? Which number would be the last number? What's the last number in 35? It's five, huh? Good job. So there'd be five ones. And how many tens would there be, guys? There'd be three tens, right? So sometimes you can look at it and you can tell, oh, I can tell by looking at this, the last number is the ones place and the second number is the tens place. So you could put them in the columns and you would know the answer just by looking at it. But if you're having a hard time, you can write them out in groups of 10 like we did, or you could use your tower or your single blocks and you can figure out how many groups of 10 there are in each and how many little ones are left over, okay? And that'll help you double check your answer if you want, okay? All right, so it does take a little bit of practice to remember the ones and the tens place, but if you practice enough, I think you'll get it. Okay, it's not that hard, and you guys did awesome. So thanks for stopping by. I'll see you guys later. Have an awesome day.